Hi guys, I'm Nandini Bajpai, and this is Instagram Live with TokaBox. So I'm a writer. I write books, and mostly I write young adult novels. I've written a bunch of books that have come out in India, like Red Turban, White Horse, which is a young adult contemporary, Starkest, which is a young adult historical, and Rishi and the Karmic Cat, which is a middle grade fantasy novel. And my new book, which is called A Match Made in Mehndi, will be out on September 14th in the US and in Canada, and on September 25th in India. So this is the first time I'm doing Instagram Live, so if I mess anything up, I'm sorry, I'm trying. So, A Match Made in Mehndi is about a young girl, Simi, who comes from a long line of Indian matchmakers. And even though she lives in New Jersey, US, her family has always been Punjabi Vichole, which is a form of matchmakers. And her mother and her Mausi think that she has the gift. She has the gift to connect people. Hi Shweta, thanks. She has the gift to connect people up and make sure they're a good match. But Simi doesn't think that, you know, matchmaking should even be a thing anymore. And she's not sure about it at all. But what she is interested in is art. And what she's interested in is trying to really have a good year in high school. And her best friend Noah and her brother Navdeep, with their help, she comes up with a dating app which is for the kids in her high school, and it goes viral. And then things get slightly out of control, and Simi has to figure out if, you know, matchmaking works for her generation, even in its new form of dating apps. So that's the new book. Please look out for it. So I have a bunch of questions that Toka parents sent to me that I'm going to try and answer for you guys. The first one is, A Match Made in Mehndi is about a girl who comes from a generation of matchmakers. How did you come up with this idea? Are there any matchmakers in your family? So no, there are no matchmakers in my family at all. But I grew up in New Delhi. And I don't know if you guys remember, in the 80s and 90s in New Delhi, there was this firm called Rishte Hi Rishte, which was, you know, when we were young kids, it was kind of amusing to us to see that ad everywhere. That ad was everywhere. If you got on a train and went anywhere in India, you would see the Rishte Hi Rishte by Professor Arora. And the tagline was, Mil tole, you know, which means let's just meet and see what happens. So nobody in my family went to a matchmaking service to get set up, but I went to a women's college, and I had a lot of friends who did have arranged marriages. And I remember that whole, you know, all the conversations around it, all the fun we had talking about it. And some of them had wonderful marriages that came from that system. But you know, my husband grew up in the US, it was completely different here. My kids have grown up here, and you know, my nieces and nephews have grown up overseas in Australia, and that generation has a completely different mindset about how people should get together. So the idea was not my idea. The idea came from Cake Literary, which is a firm that I worked with. It was their idea to write something about matchmaking. And they found me and they said, well, you have the life experience to be able to do that. So I'm like, yeah, I can write about that. I know the world in which these type of matches were made, and I do, you know, I do understand how kids today look at things. So, you know, I just took it and I went with it, and it was really fun to be in the heads of kids now and try and see how they would view their parents' generations' traditions of, you know, trying to connect people up. So question number two, the book combines tradition and contemporary culture in very interesting ways. How did you achieve this balance? So, like I said, I've lived in India, I grew up in India, and I've lived in the US now for over 20 years. So I've been able to see how people think in a traditional family, or you know, in a very normal sort of mainstream Indian family, and then how people think here when my kids were growing up and the friends that they had, how they think. So it's just taking what you know and then trying to build a story around it, build a story around characters that you can actually you know, walk in their shoes and try and guess how they would react in different circumstances, and then coming up with a plot idea and a story arc that would work, and just try and have the empathy to try and think about how different people from different generations would react in a given situation, and just try our best to be authentic. You know, try and express how they would feel and how they would react in different situations as authentically as you can. So that's how I tried to do it. So question three, we have some incredible new South Asian books for young adults, including yours. What would you like South Asian authors of YA fiction to do with the genre to take it forward? So yeah, that's absolutely true. There are so many different books right now in the young adult genre that's amazing, because when I was growing up, there were no books like that. There were none. We read books by Enid Blyton. We read the Amarchitra Kathas, which were the only things that were available that were, you know, that showed India, even though it was mythology and history half the time, but at least it showed India. But I read a lot of Enid Blyton, I read American books, I read, you know, all different kinds of books, but there were no books in which what we were living through was depicted in any way at all. So it's really amazing that they have all these books today, but it's because people tried so hard, that people spent a lot of time writing and submitting and trying to convince people in publishing that these books should be there. So right now you have young adult novels that are contemporary, set in India, set anywhere in the world, that show Indian American characters or Indian characters or Indian British characters, and that's amazing. And also you have you know, fantasy novels that take the world that we know in Asia and, you know, uses it to come up with all kinds of worlds that use that as an inspiration. There is, you know, just thinking about historical novels, there is, I think it was Light at the Bottom of the World is a new book in which, you know, London is under the sea, which sounds amazing to me. I would like to see more science fiction, if possible. Because fantasy is interesting and it's great. I also like to write fantasy, but science fiction is something I haven't seen a lot of, especially with the South Asian culture. So that is all three of the questions that I have. Does anybody else have any questions for me? Because I'm happy to answer anything.